Hi guys, welcome to my channel TechGeekyArti. In the previous video, we have created database and tables using MySQL code. We have also inserted values in marksheet table that we have created, and here is the marksheet table that we have created last time. In this video, we are going to discuss auto increment of a column, and then we will set primary keys and foreign keys. So for that, I'm going to create a table with three columns: ID, name, and grades. Here I'm going to set ID as primary key, and also I will set ID as auto increment, so we don't have to fill this column and it will auto filled with one increment, like 101, 102, and 103. The same way, I'm going to set this grade column as a foreign key. You know, foreign key is used to join two tables. So using this grade column as a foreign key, I'm going to join this table with the another table. That table name is result, and result has two columns, grade and comments. So using this grade column, I can see the result of each student. Like if a student got awesome, good, average, or poor. So primary key as ID and foreign key as grade. Let's create a table. So for creating a table, we will use create table command. And after that, we need to give location of table, which is database 2, and then the table name. And I'm going to name it marksheet 1. As in the last video, we have already created marksheet table inside database 2. So here is database 2, and here is marksheet table that we have created in the last video. Now we are going to create marksheet 1 inside this database 2. After the location and the table name, we are going to write the column names. First column is ID. Now we have to write data type, which is integer, so int, and inside brackets we will write the data size, that is 10. So I am going to take size of the column 10. That means it will take only numbers of 10 digit size. And then I am going to keep this column as not null. I also want to auto increment. So I will write auto underscore increment. Now I don't need to fill this column. It will auto increment. Next column is name. Its data size is varchar. Size I am going to take 50. This column could be null. So by default, all the columns are null. So I'm not writing null or not null, separated by a comma. Then the next column, that is GST. Its data size is, it's also a varchar, A plus B, C, A, these are varchars. Now we have to set ID as a primary key. So we will write primary key, and inside the bracket we will write the name of that column we want to set as primary key, that is ID. Now we also want to set foreign key as GST. So for that we will write command foreign key, and inside the bracket we will write GST, the table name. And here I told you foreign key is used to join one table to the another table. So here we are joining marksheet 1 table to the result table with the column grade. We also need to write the name of second table here. So for that we will give the command reference, and here the second table name, which is result, and inside that we will write column name which we are joining. Like here we are joining this grade to grade. Sorry, it's not GST, it's grade. Here also foreign key should be grade, and also result table it should be grade. Okay, let me fix this. It's actually grade. Here also let's fix the column name grade, and result it should be grade also, column name. Now close the column. So we have created a table with three columns, ID, name, and grade. We set ID as auto increment, and also we set ID as primary key. Then we set foreign key as grade column, so giving the difference to the results grade column. Keep in mind, we should have a result table with the grade column to join this table. So here I also have created a result table inside the database too. So here you can see we have result table inside the database too. This is grade and comment command. Let's execute this. Let me refresh it. And here we can see another table, which is marksheet 1, ID, name, grade. We need to fill up this table. Let's fill up values in the marksheet 1 table. So for that I am going to use insert into command and give the location database 1 dot table name marksheet 1. And then I am going to fill up the name column with the values Victor and Krish. Let's execute this command. So here we can see marksheet 1 table, and two values of name are inserted here. We have inserted only the names Victor and Chris, and ID was inserted automatically, being auto incremented 1 and 2. Here is a catch. We want to start our ID from 101, not from 1 or 2 or 3. We want our ID to start from 101. For that, we need to change the table little bit. For that, we are going to use the command alter table and then the database name dot table name, and we will write the auto increment equals to starting number, which is 101. So let's write this query here: alter table database 2 dot marksheet auto increment equals to 101. Let's execute this command, and this will change auto increment from 101. Now let's again insert values into database 2 and marksheet 1. Let's execute this command and see the marksheet 1 table. Here you can see ID values are starting from 101, then 102. And again, if you fill up more values, it will continue 103 and 100. So once you created the table, you need to change the auto increment to 101 using alter table command. That's it here. I hope you like the video. Please hit like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye bye.